Hi guys, welcome back to Amy's channel. If you are new here, you're welcome. Please don't forget to hit the subscribe button because she makes amazing content. Yeah, if you are an existing subscriber, thanks for always coming back to watch. You know we got you, man.
You can't tell that he watches my videos. Some of you said you wanted to see him again.
Here I am.
So I brought him back. And today we're going to be doing something a little bit different from my like recent content. And that's because, remember that when I mentioned in our flatmate tag, if you haven't watched that flatmate tag, it's up there, click on it and watch it. It was very interesting. Remember that I mentioned that I don't know that this guy, that I thought he was just my housemate, but he's a rich man, like he has plenty of money. Anyway, I now said, okay, oh, Mofeo, we know that you have money and you, this money matter, you are reversed. I said, come and teach my subscriber something about money. He said, no, he doesn't know what to say. I said, okay, let's not do teach about money. Let's just have a money tag where we'll answer like money questions, like interesting conversational money questions. And then maybe I can get him. He doesn't know this, but maybe I can get him to drop a few money tips inside. And then maybe also we'll probably like, what do you think? We'll probably discuss, you know, what has changed about our money habits in Nigeria and now that we're here in Lithuania, if anything has changed. So, but before that, let's just get right into the cocoa of this video, which is the tag.
Yeah.
So I have a couple of questions that I'll be asking and will be answering. Okay, so the first question is, what is your money philosophy?
Well, one of the most important things for that I believe in my money is that you need to have the right kind of mindset about money. And most of us, especially growing up where I grew up, may not have had the right kind of perspective about money and having a lot of it, and you know, how to make money, how to increase your money, how to save money, how to improve your financial status. So I think that a very important thing is to have the right mindset about money. And also, I kind of believe that if you don't want money, you're not going to get money.
Okay, so two things that I picked is that number one, money, having money is a mindset.
Mm-hmm.
And number two, if you do not want money,
you're not gonna
you can't
get
have
it.
Money, which also ties to money being a mindset.
Yeah.
So for me, what is my philosophy about money? To be honest, I'm not sure I have a philosophy about money per se, but I know that someone has actually told me that me as a person that I like the idea of money more than I like having money. And that's probably because I've never considered like having money one of my, like I've never been that person that wanted to be rich,
mm-hmm.
right? So I'm like, my own mindset is money is good, yeah, but yeah. How rich do you want to be?
Well, I really want to be rich. I mean, really, really want to be rich. I want to be super rich. I want to be someone that can be referred to as wealthy. Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah, like Bill Gates. I mean, that would be amazing. That would be super amazing.
How rich do I want to be? I feel like having that kind of money is stressful. Like, can you see how opposing our views of money is? I feel like having that kind of money is really stressful. Like, everybody on the internet will have like some think piece about how they think you should spend your money. Please, how rich do I want to be? I want enough money to be able to live a good life. And a good life for me would be to be sure that the people I care about are well taken care of, and I can sponsor my travels. And to be honest, I'm not a luxury lifestyle kind of person, so I don't even need a lot to travel. But yeah, I want to be rich, but not Bill Gates kind of rich. I have never thought of being Bill Gates kind of rich. Okay, so what's your biggest money goal?
I want to be the kind of rich where no price bothers you. Like whatever it is. Yeah,
I feel you. Basically, I feel like your biggest money goal is to be like Bill Gates. That's already a money goal.
Yeah, that's a big money goal. That's a huge one.
My biggest money goal that I can think of is, I don't know which one is more expensive, right? I want to have a beach house, okay. And then I want to buy a passport. I want to buy a citizenship. So which one do you think is more expensive?
I think the beach house should be more expensive.
So yeah, those are my two biggest money goals I can think of. A new passport and a new citizenship. What do I call it? Passport or citizenship?
Yeah, it's the same thing.
Yeah, so yeah, a new passport and then a beach house. That's all I can think first of. Thing. What was the first thing you did for money?
I don't remember how old I was, but I was a kid. You know, I think for most boys that age, we were fascinated by science and sciencey stuff. I mean, my dream then was to be, I think, a scientist or a researcher, I'm not sure. But I kind of found how to make something. Like, it's like it was a game, basically, game for my peers back in the day.
Peer-to-peer gaming.
No, not peer-to-peer gaming. It wasn't game. I mean, it was just game, like physical game.
Mad.
So, so it's something you came to play and then you kind of try to get a hoop from one end to another with a lot of obstacles. And then I wired it that if your hoop touches a line or something, it's going to bring up a bulb and then the light comes on. So that was, it was pretty basic. And then I started to charge my friends like a few naira for playing. So you gave me the money and then you played the game. Then once the
wow,
light comes on,
how old did you say you were again?
I think I should be about maybe 7 years old.
Wow,
I'm not sure.
So this did not start.
I was really young then.
I definitely was not thinking about money when I was 7. I think for me, the first thing I ever did for money was that actually I did for money and I got money, or yeah, I did for money was to sell. Like at recharge cards for phone recharge cards, because then I was in secondary school and there was my uncle then in the UK sent me 10,000 naira. 10,000 naira was like how much in dollars or euros
now?
Yeah, now
In euros should be like 20 euros plus.
Yeah, so like he sent me 20 euros. That was like a long time ago, over 10 years ago. And I said, yes, I'm going to use this to make money. And I bought recharge cards to sell. But you know how family members are, oh, give me 1,000 naira and I'll give you back. Oh, give me this, I'll pay you back. And then that's how everything disappeared. And I could not account for the money. So that was the first thing I did. What was the first salary you ever made?
Well, when I went into a career, per se, I was working for myself. So I had a startup that I was running with my co-founder, and you know how startups are.
So like you didn't get paid at all before you started your own
company? Before I started my own company, like I didn't have a job. So it was after I started my own company that I started to have a stream of income, but it wasn't salary too, so it's hard to put a figure to it.
The first salary I ever made was when I was doing my internship in school then. It was 25,000 naira. 25,000 naira is like a little less than 70 euros, so like 60-something euros per month. And I don't even think I collected the full money then, because I worked for only 2 weeks in that first place. But yes, I think I collected 30 euros. That was like first ever salary. What was the first investment you made?
My first investment, I was still in school, and so I got that money from one competition we went for. So we won and then we got paid some amount. So I thought about it, I mean, come on. You don't just make money and then spend it like that. So I wanted the money to still be able to like make more money for me. And I had a friend then that was she had a food business. and then she wanted to like get some stuff to be able to make more food and service more people. So I was like, okay, what do you think? What if I invest in your business? And then so she was like, oh great, of course. I mean, nobody says no to an investment. So the funny thing about it is actually that the amount was small. It was 40k, 40,000 naira,
which is like 100 euros.
And we actually went to a lawyer. to make it official, we drafted the terms of the investment,
nice.
How long it's going to last, what percentage of the business I'm going to. I think I still have that document too.
Did you get like profits?
I did not get my money back, but I got some money back. Not the entire investment I made, but at least it gave me the investor status for some time.
Okay, and also like made your feet wet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, in knowing how those things work.
I like the fact that you use the lawyer and stuff. Yeah. Who thinks about that? Anyway, my first investment, you guys, I remember, I won't even call it investment because at the end of the day, it was a scam and a fraud, MMM. To be honest, I did not want to do that thing because I did not believe in it. Like, mm-hmm. I was just wondering, how are you making money like that?
There was a lot of peer pressure.
My sister said she has done it, she has gotten this money out of it. They'll tell you that one, you put a certain amount of money back and you get 30% in mm-hmm. a month, something like that. Mm-hmm. And then there was nothing that we could see that money is being used for. It was just like other people's money that they were using to pay out. Basically, Ponzi scheme, Sha. Mm-hmm. How much did I put? I think I put 50,000 naira or 20,000 naira or something. and it was when I put it.
Yeah, you crashed.
It was when I put it that I crashed. I was like, never again. Never again. Because it wasn't even something I wanted to do in the first place. I should have followed my mind. So I don't know if that counts as investment because, again, it was illegitimate.
I don't know. I mean, maybe for you it was an investment because you wanted to invest the money to get more money. So, yeah. I mean, yeah, it counts.
I feel like I don't have luck with those things because another time I invested in Bitcoin and it was the period that I invested in Bitcoin and it started dropping.
But you should be happier for it now because Bitcoin is actually... The funny thing was that
what I invested, it wasn't even like I bought it. It wasn't like I had a wallet or anything. One guy just came and said, "Oh, give me this money, give me 50,000 naira, and then I'll pay you 10% of it every month for a year."
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know how that money went, but yeah, I've just had bad experiences with investments. Yeah, but I think that my first proper investment, like proper investment, was like a farming. It was a crowdfunding farming business in Adwawaye, and mm-hmm. it was worth it. Interestingly, I just even got my payouts. I think earlier this year. No, it wasn't a lot of money. Like, it wasn't a lot of money, but mm-hmm. it was just like there was a profit, so I was just happy about it. What was the first time you lost money?
Well, I don't know. I'm not sure
never
if I
lost
have.
Money.
I'm not sure
wow! If I lost wow! Money.
But I've made some investments that, you know, the business is crashed. So if that counts as losing money.
Yeah, that counts.
Okay, yeah. So, it should be a few years ago. Yeah. I mean, but it wasn't very painful to me because, you know, the person involved is someone I know, and then sometimes business, you win some, you lose some, so it is what it is.
So the first time I lost money, I mean, I've already mentioned all the many times that I lost money, but I was scammed sometime. It wasn't even a long time ago. I was scammed of, don't even ask me because I don't even think that I'm there yet to tell this story because I was so foolish. I was so foolish and I still don't make peace with myself, so let's just leave it like that. I was scammed of about almost 200,000 naira. 200,000 naira, that's like 500 euros. Yes, wow. Oh god, I don't want to think about it, but yes, I was scammed. Also, I have no love for scam artists. So, what's your biggest money flex like?
By money flex, you mean actual flexing?
Yeah, like something that you just did because you didn't have to do, but you did it because, I mean, I have money, so.
Well, that should be when my friend and I, we decided to go spend Christmas in South Africa and Kenya. So it's just... we just felt like we had worked so much that year and then wanted to kind of unwind and find a way to...
That might not be your child.
We wanted to unwind and, you know, see the world too and just have a good vacation. So I think that's probably the biggest money flex that I've had.
People, I don't have any money flex. I'm not rich enough to have money flexes. Everything I spent money, I've probably thought about it. Yes, I don't have any money flex. In fact, when I decided to travel, I traveled with my colleagues then, my friends. We did Benin, Togo, Ghana. It wasn't even a flex because it was all the money that I'd saved in my entire life that I used for that trip. So it doesn't count as a flex. Anyway, how much did you spend last week?
Last week I spent quite like a few euros less than 120 euros.
That's a lot of money. You know, I need to check how much I spent last week because I don't recall, but just give me 1 second. Don't look at
how broke I know how much I've spent is so there was this time that my friend Tommy, he mentioned something that Paul knows about every my name is Paul too.
Yeah.
Paul knows every last naira that he spent, and then I'm like, that's not true, bro. Come on, how will I know every last naira? And then I checked it and that it's true actually. Because I have an app that I log everything I spend into. So
very disciplined. I have app too, but I don't use it. Sometimes I did. I probably like I'm always like diligent for the first few days of the month, and then it just goes from there. But yeah, I probably spent like I don't know 50 euros or more. Yeah, probably like between 50 and say 70 euros last week. That's a lot of money
that's
for
a lot
a
of
week.
Money for 1 week.
What am I spending on? Well, I think that most of it went on like
grocery shopping. Yeah, it went on buying a birthday gift for me.
Oh yeah, that's true. That and then some grocery shopping. Yeah. So, what can you spend money on without thinking twice?
Well, without thinking twice, it would mostly have to do with maybe friends, family, like meeting a need.
When have you spent on me without thinking twice?
Well, I mean, all the time, I guess. So, okay, this is what I mean. Like, meeting a need is actually something that comes to me easily. Like, if somebody is in need and they reach out to me, I help as much as I can.
Mm.
That's one thing. And another thing is food, yeah. I mean, I feel like if you eat it, it's not lost.
So. Well, that makes sense to some extent. Ah, I just realized that one hand is longer than one hand. Hey, still long. Okay. what can I spend money on? Think it's like me. It's travel. Because if you notice it, let me tell you how things go, the dynamics of our money thing, like, Mofe will come and say, oh, want to order pizza or want to order burger, are you interested? I'll think, ah, I'll be like, ah, it's too expensive, I don't have money, and I'll not do it. And I'll say, oh, Mofe, let's travel to this place, let's go to Vilnius at this for the weekend, I just travel. And then he says, ah, that's a lot of money for train tickets, I don't have money. So that's it. So I think it also reflects, like, I don't think twice spending money on trips, and he doesn't think twice spending money on food.
Yeah.
So that's it. What's the most expensive thing you've ever bought?
Most expensive one thing.
Yeah, I guess.
I don't really buy stuff. Most expensive thing.
Anything.
Oh yeah, of course. My laptop.
Oh
yeah.
That makes sense. What's the most expensive thing I've ever bought or I've ever spent money on? Probably that trip that I said I exhausted all my savings. Again, it's not like the savings was plenty, but as far as I'm concerned, that's the most expensive thing that, oh God, I cannot even say this money because everyone will say this is your whole life savings. But yeah, that's the most expensive.
Please implore her to say it in the comments.
I cannot say, please, people should not ask me how much this money is. I'm begging you.
Yeah.
What's the last thing you spent money on?
It was supposed to be an audiobook, but lucky for me, I got it for free. So,
ah,
yeah,
Nice.
So what was the last thing I spent money on? I don't remember.
I'm trying to remember my own too.
Probably grocery.
Most likely.
Yeah.
You always buy it. Oh yes, I know the last thing I spent money on. Coke. I bought 2 bottles of Coke on his birthday. So that's what do you really want right now but can't afford?
There's really nothing that I wait, this is let me finish. There's really nothing I want right now that I can't afford.
Hey!
But there are wishes that I cannot afford.
Which one is what? Which one?
No, okay, I'm just trying to like separate them. Like I have fantasies of things I want to be able to do in the future.
One thing. You can't think of anything that you want that you cannot afford. Hey God.
Wait. Okay, let me think. let me think. Okay, I can't afford a Tesla. Yeah, that one.
That's what you want.
I want a Tesla, yeah.
God, you people.
Please, in case somebody wants to help my ministry.
Hey, this... Help me. You said you do estate to help somebody in need. Please, let me need. See, but the thing that I want, that I cannot afford now, is camera. Shanumi, G7X. That's what I don't even want too much. It's just G7X that I want, though. It's not even expensive like that. Mommy, please. Help me. Anyway, yeah, I want a camera. So if God lays it in your heart to, you know, contribute towards this course, and you tell me, I can open Patreon account though. I'm a creative now, I create. So if he wants me to open Patreon account so that he can support me, I will do that. So yes, that's what I want. Camera.
Yeah, maybe you should do that. That's a good idea.
Why are you going to support me?
I'm your follower and I'm a subscriber.
So will you pay?
You remember I will still watch this video too as a subscriber. Yeah. Open your Patreon account.
Yes! Okay, my first Patreon here. I'll do that and I'll open a Patreon account. So just in case, look out for my Patreon account to contribute to my ministry. So let's say that I send you a text message now or you get a text message now that you just won $1 million. From somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Like it's not like it's money tied to anything or investment or anything, you just want that money. What would you do first?
Well, apart from dancing, you mean what will I do with the money?
Yes, what would be the first thing you do with the money?
Nothing actually. I will keep it. I'll let it rest. So that I can. So there's something I do. If I know that I'm expecting some money, or that my earnings are going to change in one way or another, I have a financial plan that I follow, and then I make a review to that financial plan to accommodate the new change. So in this case, that money is sudden money, so I can't touch it yet. I will let it sit, then review my financial plan.
So wise.
And then start breaking it down.
So wise. Wow. What's going to be the first thing that I do? Oh my God. Actually, I think the first thing that I'm going to do is like send a huge... No. I won't say that I'll send a huge chunk of that money to my family, but I'll probably not, because I feel like I don't trust my father to be wise with it. It's just in case my father
they will come for you and this video.
but I think that the first thing that I'll do if I got $1 million is all the things that I need for filming gear. Everything. And I'm going to employ somebody to be editing for me, because I'll just do all those things. And after that, I don't know. I really want to take this YouTube ministry to the next level, and I'll save that money as an investment. I'll just like do everything that I need to do, get gears and all of that. And I'm serious, I'll actually send a huge chunk of that money to my family, because I mean my father has like business plans that he has shared with me, because so I'll see that as a way to support him and his business. So I'll definitely send a huge chunk of that.
I mean, that's really wise too. Wise spending. See?
I guess. Anyway, we've come to the end of the questions, but we've not come to the end of this video.